History Month Assembly. This year, our theme is Black Art. I'm Jade Bowden, and I'm a Vice Youth President, and our theme this year is Black Art, Through the Decades, a collective piece to honor the past and look forward to the future. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to ask that everybody in the audience please rise as Ms. Adedoyin Mayeni and Ms. Jessica Bangura present their rendition of Lift Every Voice and Sing, the Black National Anthem.
Lift every voice and sing till the heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let every sound loud as the rolling sea sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has brought us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun, we will march on till victory is won.
Black art is extremely important, but what about the black artists in America? There are many famous black artists that have made important contributions to artwork in America. Artists such as Gordon Parks, one of the greatest photographers of the 20th century. Mr. Parks was a humanitarian with a deep commitment to social justice. He left behind an exceptional body of work that documents American life and culture from the early 40s all the way up until the 2000s. He, with the focus on race relations, poverty, civil rights, and urban life. The work displayed on the screen is titled Department Store from Mobile, Alabama. This photograph was part of Gordon Parks' 1956 photo essay for Life magazine that was documenting the life of the Thornton family under segregation in Alabama. Thank you.
On the topic of 20th century artists, one known for his unique style movement, my boy Ernie Barnes. Now, bro was the first American pro athlete, not just a black American pro athlete, but the first American pro athlete to become a noted painter. Now, his works are shown, collected, and respected internationally. That's all around the world, for those who don't know what that means. And in pop culture, Barnes' artwork appears on many album covers, movies, and TV shows, notably his iconic dancehall scene named Sugar Shack, which is showcased on the 1970s TV hit series, Good Times.
Last but certainly not least is Amy Sherrill. Ms. Sherrill has revitalized the genre of portraiture with elegance, composure, and formal balance. In her pictures, the subjects are African American. Working from stage photographs, her pieces present a simplified realism which transmits a message as well as the power of stereotypical imagery of African-American subjects. In the societal standing of the people she depicts, resetting the traditional canons of identity, revisiting what an official portrait is, and writing Black history. Here we have her most famous portrait title, Michelle LaVon Robinson Obama Oil Woman, the official portrait of our former First Lady, Michelle Candid in 2018.
There are countless Black artists. We even have great talent here at AHS, like Dana Abbey that created the t-shirts that we are all wearing. Some of her artists presented here on the slides representing realistic portrait art. Chastity McNamara, who drew this powerful image of Malcolm X. Charnel Wells, who created this piece showcasing the replication of the quote that represents the past that slaves had to use to escape slavery. And Kiana Rose, who painted the amazing portrait of the Black woman representing self-love along with how we uplift one another. If you are interested in learning more about Black artists, please use this QR code and discover more.
No.
Dance has always been an art form that is used to convey messages to the world. All cultures use dance to express their feelings and to display their beauty. African American dance is no different. During slavery, many plantation owners denied enslaved people to use their customary jobs. So what did we do best? We improvised. We danced to communicate, we danced to remember our history, and we still dance to show how strong we are. Please welcome the EHS Dance Ensemble as they perform to Rihanna's Lift Me Up from Wuhan the Dress.
Lift me up, oh.
Thank you, dance ensemble. Now let's have some fun. Please turn your attention to the side panels. I'll randomly call someone, and first person to get it right will win this t-shirt. It's trivia time. Soul Train, the iconic dance music show that lasted from 1971 to 2006, was created and hosted by which TV presenter? Montel Williams, Arsenio Hall, or Don Cornelius?
American spoken word poetry first originated during the early 20th century. This form is influenced by the poetry of the Harlem Renaissance, Beat Generation, and Last Poets. It is meant for performance and incorporates the wordplay, alliteration, and intonation of ancient oral traditions. Now, we bring spoken word poetry to EHS. Please welcome Kalique Williams performing I Too by Langston Hughes.
I Too by Langston Hughes. I Too sing America. I'm the darker brother they send me to eat in the kitchen when company comes, but I laugh and eat well and grow strong. Tomorrow I'll be at the table when company comes. They'll dare say to me, eat in the kitchen then. Besides, they'll see how beautiful I am and be ashamed. I am too America.
Now we have Simone Bank performing When a Black Man Walks.
You ever see a black man walk? It's like rhythm in me to get up off the page and decided to move and glide like a spirit. You ever see a black man walk into a room, Morse code style, like keys, tap dancing, I'm here, and those steps are messages, and you have to listen carefully, they're trying to kill me, stop searching, frisk me, there are prayers in a black man's walk. Don't let them shoot me down where I'm standing. Don't let the white chalk outlines find me. Don't let me die in the streets like an animal. I'm a man, I swear, I'm a man. When a black male walks, a whole generation lives to see another day, another sunrise, another mouth to feed, another seed, another sacrifice saved, another poem, another hungry burning cross, another mother breathing in her son's ear. Move easy, move quiet. Don't matter if you're 16 or 60, when a black man walks, wait for it. Listen to the orchestra playing beneath his feet. Pay attention to the vibrations when he walks into the room. See how many faces change to fear in the presence of a black man. See how many women hold their purses so tightly their fingers grow numb. See how many men hide their eyes wishing the darkness would go away. Maybe choke themselves to death, that ugly two-thirds human being, that next to nothing black dot, that useless prison black spot. When a black male walks, every day he is a man, paranoid of crucifixion, knowing his hoodie had nothing to do with his last breath, if only bullets could kill racism, poverty, and the traumas of slavery. You pay attention when a black man walks. His feet got a mind of their own, a compass, a homing device, 400 years of direction. Find your way home safely. Don't let Jim Crow steal your dog. When his feet are already covered in his own blood, do what your mama said to do. Run, run, run. Death is always like black men are the easiest to find. They are the strongest, but the most fragile. They are the calm of the storm. They die like they expected to. When a black male walks, think of it as a masterpiece, a beautiful song that you can only hear once. Cherish it. You may never hear it again. Thank you.
Our hair has been the most important part of our identity. It's not just hair, it's our soul, our history, our love, our voice. Recent legislation, such as the Crown Act, that was created to prohibit discrimination based on our hairstyle and hair texture by clarifying that such discrimination is illegal under existing federal law, recognizes the importance of black hair. As shown on the side panels, black hair has evolved throughout the decades.
So y'all already know that we can rock just about any hairstyle that can be thought of. And here at EHS, we display that on a daily basis. Here is the best of the best of black hair at our school.
See, y'all can kind of recall a little ways back, small trying to fall, always been black, and my hair I tried it all. I even went flat, had a gummy curl on top and all that crap. Now, I was trying to make it appreciated, happy in the dollars, never had no ladies. Then I hit the barbershop real quick, had to be good to the city, drove me crazy. I couldn't get no job, corporate women, I had no dreadlocks. Then I thought about my dogs on the block, and I understand why the drones are still in raw. Was it the hair that got me this far? But it seemed so flawed. Success didn't come till I cut it all off. Little girl with a press curl, age old, had a cherry curl. 13 and I got a relaxer. I was the size of so much like her. 15 and it all broke out. 18 when I went on natural. February 2002, I went on to do what I had to do. Because it was time to change my life.
Glasses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To support their students academically, socially, and support the surrounding community. Stepping became a way that the numbers of these students and groups expressed love and pride for their organizations. Stepping is a percussive, highly energetic art form. In stepping, the body becomes an instrument using footsteps, claps, and spoken word to produce complex polyrhythms. Of course, we here at EHS have our own step team, and if you've seen us in the past, you know it's about to go down. If you're new, be prepared. Now, let's give it up for our very own EHS Diamonds and our choreographer, Janai Smallwood.
Had an enormous impact on music. Lately, we have started celebrating the genre Afrobeats more often. Started by Fela Kuti during the period of unrest in Nigeria, Afrobeats has played a major role in not only popular culture, but in politics as well. With a mixture of American jazz, blues, and funk, it has come to establish Nigeria as a harbor for musical innovation and continues to influence popular culture in today's generation. Now, please stand and join us in the EHS Dance Ensemble as we line dance to Jerusalem by Master Keiji with a special choreography by Janai Smallwood. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, now,